Good day and welcome to Big Bad Tech. I'm your instructor, Jim Pytel, and today's topic of discussion is resistors in series. Our objective is to take a look at series or inline configurations of resistors. Additionally, we'll discuss the influence of shorts and opens inside series circuits. This lecture operates the presumption the viewer has more than a passing familiarity of the 4-band resistor color code. If you haven't watched this lecture yet, or only dimly recall its contents, please take the time to do so now. A resistor is a component that resists, controls, or otherwise opposes the movement of electrical charges. Simple resistors are two terminal components with fixed standard values and come in various power ratings. The polarity or orientation of a resistor doesn't matter. I mean, you can flip it around and connect it however you want, such that current goes in either direction. This is not always the case for all components. You find other components, such as diodes, purposely block current in one direction and allow it to flow in the other. Other components, such as certain types of capacitors, can be irreparably damaged if you hook them up incorrectly. The point is, pay attention to the markings on the outside of a component, obey manufacturer's recommendations, and hook it up like you're supposed to. A circuit is a complete path or a closed loop. The loop could be a single, circular, rectangular, triangular, or any other shape forming a complete loop, or composed of many different pathways that at least one of which allows a passage from one terminal or voltage source to the other. Without at least a single closed loop, there is no circuit and there is no way conventional current can flow from the positive terminal to the negative terminal. A closed circuit requires a closed path for current to flow. Circuits composed of multiple resistors can assume numerous different configurations, perhaps the simplest being a series or inline configuration. A series arrangement means there is one path and one path only. Here's an example of a series circuit consisting of a resistor 1 having a value of 330 ohms between node A and B, and resistor 2 having a value of 560 ohms between node B and C. It should be obvious that any current emanating from the positive terminal of the source must travel into resistor 1, out of resistor 1, into resistor 2, and out of resistor 2 to reach the negative terminal of the source. This implies that the source sees a total resistance equal to the summation of resistor 1 and resistor 2. That's it. Series resistances add up. Do you need a formula to remember this? For this series circuit consisting of a 330 ohm resistor in series with a 560 ohm resistor, the source sees a total resistance of 330 plus 560 or 890 ohms. Too easy. This implies that the source would be none the wiser if the series combination of two resistors was swapped out and a single 890 ohm resistor took their place. This easier visualization can be used in circuit analysis to simplify the analysis procedure. You'll note the shorthand for resistors in series is addition, implying a series simplification has occurred. Let's put your understanding of this simple concept to the test with this series of example problems. For each series circuit, determine the total resistance seen by the source. Express all answers using proper engineering format to the tenth place. By all means, pause the lecture and try this on your own. If you're tracking, you should have obtained the following values. For the first circuit, the source sees a total resistance of 1,000 plus 680, or 1,680 ohms, or more appropriately, roughly 1.7 kiloohms. The second circuit first necessitates interpretation of the 4-band resistor color code. Red, purple, brown is 27, followed by 10, or 270 ohms. Purple, green, brown is 75, followed by 10, or 750 ohms. And finally, gray, red, brown is 8.2, followed by 10, or 820 ohms. The source sees the summation of 270, 750, and 820 for a total of 1,840 ohms, or more appropriately, roughly 1.8 kiloohms. Finally, for our third circuit, the source sees a summation of 330, 240, 470, and 430 ohms for a total of 1,470 ohms, or more appropriately, roughly 1.5 kiloohms. Note how the total resistance of a series combination is always larger than the largest resistor. If your calculations or observations suggest otherwise, you are doing it wrong. Series resistances always add up. Here's another set of series circuit example problems, each with the intent of illustrating an important property of resistors taken in series. See if you can determine the total resistance seen by each source for each of these series circuits. Express all answers using proper engineering format to the tenth place. Be on the lookout for interesting results. By all means, pause the lecture and try this on your own. If you're tracking, you should have obtained the following values. The first three circuits are just different configurations of the same three resistors in different orders. As such, the total resistance for each of these circuits is 1,770 ohms, or more appropriately, roughly 1.8 kiloohms. This example is intended to illustrate that the order of resistors constituting a series circuit does not influence the total resistance seen by the source. Any series configuration of these same three resistors in any order always results in a total resistance of roughly 1.8 kiloohms. For our fourth circuit, the source sees a total resistance of 2,480 ohms, or more appropriately roughly 2.5 kiloohms. This example was intended to illustrate an important time-saving feature for series circuits composed of identical resistors. The total resistance of a series combination of identical resistors is the resistance value times the number of resistors having that value. 620 plus 620 plus 620 plus 620 equals roughly 2.5 kiloohms, as does 4 times 620. Finally, for our fifth circuit, the source is a summation of 0.5 ohms, 200 ohms, and 180 kiloohms for a total of 180,200.5 ohms, or more appropriately, roughly 180.2 kiloohms. This example was intended to illustrate two facts. One, that the largest resistor in a series relationship, in this case the obscenely large 180 kiloohm resistor, seems to dominate the whole relationship, and two, the smallest resistor in this series relationship, in this case our minuscule 500 milliohm resistor, or 0.5 ohm resistor, seems to get lost in the noise. Let's now discuss the influence of opens and shorts inside series circuits. Opens are breaks with infinite resistance through which no current can flow. Shorts, in contrast, are zero-ohm paths around other elements through which current can flow. Let's first examine the influence of opens in series circuits. Consider the series combination of a 510, 390, and a 220 ohm resistor. Ordinarily, this circuit would have a total resistance of 1,120, or roughly 1.1 kiloohms. If, however, there existed a gaping hole between the first two resistors, the total resistance of this series path is now infinite. This is an open circuit through which no current can flow. Due to the inclusion of the open, the source effectively sees an infinite resistance because no conductive path exists. Consider a rearrangement of this same series circuit, this time including a gaping hole between the last two resistors. This is again an open circuit through which no current can flow. Due to the inclusion of the open, the source effectively sees an infinite resistance because no conductive path exists. In summary, an open anywhere in a series path completely severs that path. It makes sense. A series or inline path with a rupture or open anywhere in that single path does not have a conductive path. Functionally, opens in series circuit can take the form of switches, the status of which controls the fundamental on or off state of the complete circuit. An open switch anywhere in a series circuit halts all current flow and de-energizes the complete system. Conversely, a closed switch allows current to flow and energizes the system. Let's now deal with shorted elements in series circuits. A short is a low resistance path around or in parallel with an element. Consider a 510 ohm resistor with a 0 ohm wire in parallel or around the resistor. Think about it. When presented with a 510 ohm path or a 0 ohm path, through which would a majority of electrons travel? Undoubtedly, the 0 ohm short presents a far easier means of travel from end to end. All current will be routed around the shorted resistor. The shorter resistor effectively presents a 0 ohm resistance path. As previously, consider the series combination of a 510, a 390, and a 220 ohm resistor. Ordinarily, the circuit will have a total resistance of 1,120 ohms, or roughly 1.1 kiloohms. If, however, we included a short or 0 ohm path around the 510 ohm resistor, all current will be routed around the 510 ohm resistor. Thus, the total resistance of the series path is now only the series combination of the 390 and 220 ohm resistor, or 610 ohms, implying that the shorted 510 ohm resistor is essentially excluded from consideration. If we return the 510 ohm resistor to its original configuration and short the 220 ohm resistor, the source effectively sees only the series combination of the 510 and 390 ohm resistor for a total resistance of 900 ohms, implying that the shorted resistor is essentially excluded from consideration. All current will be routed around the shorted 220 ohm resistor. In summary, a shorted element in a series path removes only the shorted element from consideration. Before we bring this lecture to a close, consider this oddity. A circuit consisting of four resistors, only three of which present a complete series path, the fourth just dangling out in space. How does the source see this combination of resistors? To answer this question, think how current travels through this circuit. Any source current leaving the positive terminal of the source must travel through the 510 ohm resistor, through the 390 ohm resistor, and through the 220 ohm resistor to reach the negative terminal of the source, implying that no current travels through the 100 ohm resistor dangling out in space and can be effectively removed from consideration. The source still sees the series combination of the 510, 390, and 220 ohm resistor for a total resistance of 1,120 ohms, or more appropriately, roughly 1.1 kiloohms. In summary, resistors must be in the single path to be considered part of a series circuit. Series circuits are inline configurations of resistor through which current flows end-to-end. All right, that's about it for today. In conclusion, this lecture took a look at series or inline configurations of resistors. We learned resistors in series add up and discuss the influence of order in series circuits, identical resistors in series circuits, abnormally large and abnormally small resistors in series circuits, and the influence of shorts and opens inside series circuits. Remember to review these concepts as often as you need to really drive it home. Imagine how well lab will go if you know what you're doing. Thank you very much for your attention and interest, and we'll see you again during the next lecture of our series. Remember to tell your Lazy Lab partner about this resource, and be sure to check out the Big Bad Tech channel for additional resources and updates.